if you come from Hungary. Wow, big turnout. Hi, welcome everybody. Are there people here from Slovakia in the room here today? Woo! Welcome. And we also have locals, Austrians or people. Yeah!
Dear sisters and brothers, you brothers. We already spent the morning in the city. It was a very nice walk, although there was some rain. At this point, I also want to thank Herbert Sutter, who did the tour guiding for us. Let's give him a big applause. Organizations gathered together for special occasions. And we are very glad that we have this place. And also we are happy to welcome you here today, especially from the neighboring countries, Slovakia and Hungary, but also from Austria and also from Switzerland or Europe. So welcome.
She is our current president of the Women's Federation for World Peace here in Austria and the secretary of Women's Federation for World Peace UN team, and she's also the deputy of the secretary of the NGO Committee of Aging. She's a beautiful woman with 5 children, and she really puts so much heart into the work she does. So let's welcome her.
I want to enjoy for this very nice introduction. I also want to say thank you for the a technical person who is the husband of Elizabeth Tony Cook, who really is helping us each time we need help in this area. So I'm very happy to be here after the rain in the city, and we had a nice lunch that was cooked by a brother, actually. This is a family, a friend of a friend's family, and the daughter was here soon. So I think it was a good idea to eat together in the house here, not having to go outside again. I've joined the Women Federation in 1992. The Women Federation for World Peace has been founded in 1992 by a couple, not by women alone, by Dr. Hak-Chan Moon and her husband. And I think even at that point, the husband understood much more the importance of women. It is something Moon, I'm sure you knew, you heard about, and I'm deeply, deeply, deeply impressed. Even now, when my children are big, because they're grown up now, so I'm reading and a lot more, and I realize how much he pushed his women to go forward, asking every one of us to become who we truly are, because the female aspect is so important in the world. If it's missing, then so much is missing. And so if we understand as women who we really are, and we learn and encourage each other, and I think this is the meaning of such an event also, that we can embrace each other, we can talk together, and we can be strengthened again to go out and be who we really are. Because actually, there's only one person whom we have to ask, who is me? When we're grown up, and it's more we can ask our parents, what is my value? What is my parents always support the children? But somehow we grow up, most of us are here grown up, I think everyone's grown up. But we have the heavenly parents. I'm so grateful for having heavenly parents. And I'm so grateful, I think we all come from kind of Christian background, so we know the first part in the Bible. God created kind and is man and woman, male and female. And I'm so grateful for this, because it always gives me the courage. Sometimes it's really pushing me to go out and think, oh, maybe I want to sit home and I want to meet somebody.